Dear family and friends of Jesse and Emily, we are gathered here to celebrate their union in marriage. The holy relationship of marriage was instituted by the Lord from the beginning, and being of divine appointment, it is therefore honored among all peoples. It is to be entered into joyfully, thoughtfully, lovingly, and reverently. With this desire, these two persons come now to be united. Jesse, do you take this woman to be your wife, that you may live together in the holy bond of marriage? Will you strive to love and honor her? Will you comfort her and be faithful to her so long as you both shall live? Emily, do you take this man to be your husband, that you may live together in the holy bond of marriage? Will you strive to love and honor him? Will you comfort him and be faithful to him so long as you both shall live?
I'm Rod Kelly. I'm Emily's grandpa. I think the oldest one here. I was really honored when Emily and Jesse called me and asked me to do the reading this afternoon. It's really, really an honor and a privilege for me that they should pick me out in this perspective right here. They've chosen part of Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, to the Christians in Corinth. There was much discord in Corinth at that time, just as we are all experiencing today in our present life, in the present world. I believe there is much advice, good advice, for all of us here, as well as Jesse and Emily, as there was 2,000 years ago for the Christians at Corinth. A reading from part of the 13th chapter of St. Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not jealous. Love is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing. It reconciles with truth, rejoices with truth. It bears all things, believes all things, endures all things. So faith, hope, and love remain. But the greatest of these is love. And so Jesse and Emily, and all of us here present, if we follow these guidelines, you and we will truly experience Christian love and a life of peace. Remember to judge your actions by whether you can say, I love you because of what you've done, or I love me. Now I'd ask all of you to please stand. And I want you to hold up your right hand. I'm going to read an Irish blessing. Anybody surprised about that? May there always be work for your hands to do. May your purse always hold a dime and a coin or two. May there always be sunshine on your window pane. And may a rainbow follow each rain. May the hand of a friend always be near you. May God fill both of your hearts with love and gladness to cheer you. May God grant you both wisdom beyond your age. May God bless you both. And let your love ever endure. Let us all say, amen. Sickness and in health, to love and to cherish.
Lord our God, we ask your blessing upon these rings, that they may be constant symbols of unending love and devotion. With this ring, I be wed and pledge my faithful love. With this ring, I be wed and pledge my faithful love.
Lord, inspire those men and women who bear the title husband and wife. Help them to look to you, to themselves, to one another, to rediscover the fullness and mystery they once felt in their union. Let them be honest enough to ask, where have we been together and where are we going? Let them be brave enough to question, have we failed? Help them together to re-examine their commitment in the light of your love. Willingly, openly, and compassionately. Help them together to believe how fragile yet powerful, and how weak yet how strong, how impossible yet attainable their love can be. And so, Jesse and Emily will have the title of husband and wife. And I hope you have the courage to be for each other a person rather than a title. Amen.
Would you all join me in an attitude of prayer? O God, our heavenly creator, fountain of all life and love in heaven and on earth, we ask your blessing upon these solemn vows of love and duty which Jesse and Emily have here assumed. Give them a deep and abiding sense of their dependence upon you, that they may continually look to you for help and direction. Quicken in their hearts that supreme love to you, which alone can make their love for each other pure, unselfish, and abiding. May the burdens and trials which they must mutually bear draw them ever nearer to you and to each other. May they be truly grateful for the precious blessings which are the fruits of this holy relation. Make them ever thoughtful and gentle, patient and forbearing, regardful of each other's feelings and opinions, and lenient to each other's infirmities. In all the experiences of life, give them one heart, one mind, and one way. Amen. For as much as you, Jesse, and you, Emily, and have witnessed the same before the Lord in this company, giving and pledging your faith to each to the other, I now pronounce you are husband and wife, and make this pride.
Young now.
Yeah, they get up there.